audience gathered here.
Good morning to our honorable guests, parents, grandparents, friends and well-wishers who have come to grace this beautiful occasion on this lovely morning.
Here we have our dear principal, Reverend Father Johnson Sikwara, our vice principal, Mrs. Rita Cordes, escorting majestically our esteemed guest, Mrs. Manjula K, correspondent, Very Reverend Father Valerian Manasa, Secretary Mr. Gresham Patello, and other dignitaries to the venue. Let us all rise to welcome our esteemed guest.
I'm Charmi.
And I am Ayan.
We both are friends in UKG.
We are the masters of ceremony for this annual day celebration of kindergarten section of St. Mary's English Medium School.
Prayer works wonders, prayer springs from the heart. Our friends are also to thank God for His blessings with the prayer.
To the days.
Valerian Manasa, are here with us in our school on this special day.
We call upon Diana of UKGD to welcome the gathering.
A very cool morning to one and all present here. Today is a special and memorable occasion, one that we'll remember in the years ahead. It is the time to chill, to cheer and to shine. It is an honor to be surrounded by so many special people and to be blessed on this gracious occasion. It's my pleasure to start this auspicious occasion by heartily welcoming everybody. We are privileged to have Mrs. Manjula K, the BA of Udupi, as our esteemed guest. She is from Tirthahalli. She started her career as a teacher in a government school in Bangalore Rural District in year 1998 and is presently posted in Udupi as BA from January 28, 2019. She is a proud parent of Abhigna Stadden and a student of our school. I extend a hearty welcome to you, ma'am. We are really blessed to have Very Reverend Father Valerian Maronza as a correspondent, a person who loves music, who speaks through music, and who spreads love all around with his warm smile like a gentle breeze. With his warm welcome to you, Father. A cordial welcome to the secretary, Mr. Gresham Botello, all the members of the management committee of Mother of Saurashtra Udupi, and the heads of sister concern. A special welcome to our dear principal, Reverend Father Johnson Sequela, who inspires us. In every morning with his radiant smile, he is the person to be found in every corner of the school. With his cheerful and confident walk, with his joyful welcome to you, Father. I heartily welcome to our Vice Principal, Mrs. Rita Cordes, who inspires us to do all our activities. She's always there to guide us at any time of the day. A jovial welcome to you, ma'am. Mummies and daddies, grandpas and grandmas, uncles and aunts, you have made a day very special by your presence. You are the most amazing gift God has given us. We love you all. A welcome hug to each one of you. The fragrance of flowers spreads only in the direction of the mind, but the goodness of the person spreads in all directions. Our teachers are the best. Their enthusiasm to make us do all the activities is really appreciable. We welcome all of them and a warm welcome to our non-teaching staff for their selfless service. It's my urgent pleasure to welcome all my dear friends. You're all going to rock today. We welcome all of them and wish you a splendid time with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Diana.
Diana did welcome you, but now I request Usha ma'am to formally welcome and introduce the guest.
Good morning. A fresh, lively morning with a promising start to a fun-filled day awaits us all this November month, a month of crimson sunsets. The stage is all set to unfold a celebration of vision, a starburst of colors, joy, and splendor. We bow our heads in respect to greet our honorable guest and all present here. It's a happy day full of joy and exhilaration as we celebrate our kindergarten annual day. Music is a divine way to tell beautiful poetic things to the heart. We have with us our very own Reverend Father, Very Reverend Father Valerian Mendoza, a musician whole and soul, who assumes the presidential chair this morning. His cordiality and charming manners His smooth flow of words has always put us at ease. He holds this institution in his heart as a spiritual animator and a good pastor, and has shown his care and concern for us. It gives us immense joy to welcome you, dear Father. I request our principal to give a floral welcome to our correspondent. I am indeed honored and proud to welcome and introduce our chief guest, Mrs. Manjula K., Block Education Officer of Udupi. She took up the noble profession of teaching for a noble cause. She worked as a teacher in Government Boys School, Hoskote, Bangalore Rural District. After passing her Karnataka Education Service exam, she became headmistress of Government High School, Hosnagar Taluk. Got promoted as a senior lecturer in District Institute of Education and Training. Died Udupi in the year 2018-19. Now she is the Block Education Officer of Udupi, who leads all the education institution of Udupi district. She is an efficient leader and a good administrator. It's my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to you, ma'am. Your presence makes us very happy. I request Vice Principal to give a floral welcome to our chief guest. A cordial welcome to the Secretary of Parish Pastoral Church of Udupi, Udupi Church, Mr. Gratian Botello, and all the school management committee members. I request Mrs. Smita D'Souza to give a floral welcome to the secretary. We are gifted to have a man of creative ideas, fertile imaginations, stupendous energy, and inexhaustible passion for service. A man to serve, not to be served. Our dear principal, Reverend Father Johnson Sequeira. His tireless effort has flowered into the shimmering silver lining, glowing bright today. The courage to make tough decisions and the compassion to listen to the need of others is an art. A principal does not set out to be a leader, but becomes a special one by the equality of his action and integrity of his intent. The quote above said is very much filling to our principal. You are our leader. With a thankful heart, we welcome you, dear Father. I request Mr. Reynolds to give a floral welcome to our principal. With all my affable greetings, I cordially welcome our dear Vice Principal, Mrs. Rita Cordes, who leads us and guides us in the bringing out the best in the children. You show motherly love, give fatherly confidence. Your endless care, guidance, and support prove that you are a great leader. Welcome to you, ma'am. I request Mrs. Wilma to give floral welcome to our vice principal. We welcome our assistant parish priest, Mother of Sorrows Church, Udupi, Father Stephen Fernandez. A bounteous welcome to you, dear Father. Education is shared commitment between dedicated teachers, motivated students, and enthusiastic parents. Dear parents, you being the first teachers have the potential to play an immensely proactive role. You are like the proverbial complementary wheels of progress. To the world, you may be the person, but to your child, you are the world. We feel deeply cherished to offer a pleasant welcome to each one of you, as you are the beam of support for all the efforts taken. A warm welcome to the heads and deans of our sister concerns. Your presence has enhanced our joy. Dear teachers, you are not just teachers. You are the managers of the world's greatest resource, children. God created teachers to make a difference in the world. A hearty welcome to all my colleagues for planting the seeds of knowledge to produce tomorrow's dreams. The beauty that surrounds us in this school is absolutely breathtaking. It's the smiling faces of the children. The soul is healed by being with the children. At the end of the day, the most overwhelming key to success is to unfold the suppressed potential of our children and make them useful citizens of the future. You, dear children, are the gem of this institution. A loving welcome to you all. A humble welcome to the non-teaching staff on this occasion, without whom no activity of the kindergarten will go smoothly. A cordial welcome to the photographer, videographers, decorators, and print and media for their assistance in making this event colorful. A warm welcome to one and all.
Thank you, ma'am.
We do so many things in school, mummies and daddies. Have you ever wondered what we really do in school? I'm sure you do like to see them.
I request Reverend Father Johnson Sikwara, our dear principal, to present a brief PowerPoint presentation.
A pleasant morning to everyone gathered in the St. Mary's Auditorium. Respected dignitaries on the dais, members of the management committee, invited guests, parents, staff, and students. It is my proud privilege to place before this August assembly a brief annual report of our school for the academic year 2019-20. St. Mary's English School, with its vision of presenting socially responsible and morally upright global citizens to our society, greatly remembers the visionary late Reverend Father J.P. Thauru, who established this school in the year 1984. Since then, this institute has been excellent in drawing out the best from every student who enters the portals of this school through academic and value education. With all its resourcefulness and preparedness, the school has emerged as the prestigious and well-sought-after educational institution of Udupi district. The greatest asset of our school lies in our committed and dedicated staff. The total staff on roll is 112, which includes 71 teaching and 41 non-teaching. We have 1,437 students on roll. CBSE results. Our students are our success story. We have secured 100% results in class 10th and 12th CBSE board examination held in March 2019. Out of 103 students who appeared for 10th board exam, 22 students have passed with 90% and above, and 18 students above 85%. Ms. Shauna Hazel D'Souza is the topper of the school with an extraordinary achievement of scoring 96.4%. Out of 31 students who appeared for the class 12th exam, 8 students secured 85% and above. Ms. Chanel Matthias is the topper in science with 89.6%, and Ms. Varshita R. Suvarna in commerce with 87.6%. We congratulate students as well as teachers for the laudable achievement. Change of guard. I was warmly welcomed as the principal of this school on 27 May this year. We sincerely acknowledge the valuable services of former principal and Ms. Vice Principal, Ms. Myrtle L.F. Lewis and Mrs. Deepa Bandari, respectively, to the growth of this institute. We wish every success to our new Vice Principal, Mrs. Rita Quadras. Academics. Our Tiny Charms academic performance is measured in a series of activities with a lot of emphasis on learning orally and through doing process. The day starts with prayer and exercise. The exciting and energetic activities conducted every day enhance the cognitive, social, expressive, and interactive language and vocabulary skills. Scribbling, stringing beads, coloring, number knowledge, storytelling, and singing rhymes develop the emotional, ethical, and psychomotor aspects of child's life. We focus on preparing our little masters to compete with the present world, inculcating moral values in them by paying individual attention and care and help them gain confidence in everything they do. Spiritual life. We here in St. Mary's strongly believe that spiritual life is at the core of our existence. We begin and conclude our days in school by thanking and praising God. The Catholic students have weekly mass and confessions once a month. Catechism and moral science classes are being conducted twice a week. This way, we strive to impart holistic education to everyone. Collaboration with parents. We all are aware that a child's learning can greatly be enhanced by successful parent-teacher collaboration. I must very humbly acknowledge that our parents are inseparable entity of our institute. To enrich parenting experience, Dr. Varalakshmi Chandrasekharan, Dr. Leena Ashok, well-known psychologist, and our school counselor, Mrs. Ashwita D'Souza, have given elaborative sessions to our parents. The parents of class 9th and 10th also had career guidance program along with their children by Mr. Ronald Pinto in order to set proper goals and channelize their energy in right direction. Kindergarten parents had sessions separately to guide and motivate the young learners. I'm very happy to note that most of the parents were present for various activities organized in the school. Today, you dear parents are here with us, which shows how affectionate and responsible you are. Teachers' Professional Development Program. In keeping with school's policy of continuous upgradation of knowledge and skills, our teachers attended various in-service training programs organized under the aegis of CBSE to improve their academic competence through life skills, teaching skills through gender sensitivity, integrity and ethics, problems of children of alcoholic parents, and teacher as a counselor to update their life coping skills. Teachers' club activities on every fourth Saturday revitalize the spirit of every teacher of our institute. Emphasis on co-scholastic areas. Co-curricular activities are significant for enriching students on an emotional, cognitive, physical, and social level. St. Mary's is a hub of co-curricular activities. Clay modeling, palm thumb printing, collage of birds and animals, thread painting, Rakhi, clay pot painting, Gurudipa, Diya painting, fruit salad, star and greeting card making are being conducted for kindergarten students, which are remodeled into competitions for class 1 to 12th. Students of 10th are also given a village exposure program to study the village lifestyle and agriculture practices as a part of education. Our school also facilitates students to excel in karate, Bharatanatyam, Western dance, drawing and music. Clubs such as consumer, literary, science, maths and YSM, and movements such as bunnies, cubs and bulbuls, scouts and guides, an NCC naval wing give wings to the ideas of our students. This year too, our students actively participated in intramural and intramural sports competitions and have won laurels. Our students have represented the school in various tournaments of IKES and CBSE. We celebrated our annual sports day on 30th September and 1st of October. We appreciate the hard work of our students who are just entering into the competitive world and the teachers who are training and supporting them. Morning assemblies are conducted by different classes in three different languages to develop the love for the language. We wish children who celebrate their birthdays to create child-friendly atmosphere. School cabinet members promise to join hands with the faculty to make St. Mary's family a happy family. All national and religious festivals are celebrated with the feelings of patriotism, integrity, and harmony. Social responsibility. With the purpose of making our students socially conscious towards the less privileged and poor, we observed Gandhi Jayanti in a meaningful way by taking part in community outreach program. Around 500 students in 7 groups visited 11 different orphanages, old age homes, hospitals and rehabilitation centers in and around Udupi. Students presented entertainment programs, conducted games to spread happiness in their lives and offered various household items as a mark of school's social responsibility. Tidings of happiness. We extend a cordial invite to all of you to Ike's Athletics Kelosav for the CBSE and ICSE schools of Udupi district on Saturday, 30th of November in our school ground. Hearty welcome to the prize distribution day on 17th December. Do come and encourage your children. The Government of India has selected our school for setting up Atal Tinkering Lab, ATL, under Atal Innovation Mission, aim of Niti Aayog. It's another feather added to the cap of St. Mary's. It will help our students to have a hand-on activities based on science and technology. A bouquet of gratitude. Ladies and gentlemen, St. Mary's grows mightier year by year. On this day of high importance, we bow our heads to the Almighty and our patron Mother Mary for all blessings. We're extremely grateful to our correspondent, Very Reverend Father Valerian Mendonca, for sharing his expertise in the field of education to our growth and also providing us the necessary facilities to the school in this academic year. We thank all the members of the school management committee for their unending support. We thank Mrs. Manjula K., BEO of Udupi, for gracing this occasion as our chief guest. We recognize the meaningful service of our vice principal, Mrs. Rita Cordes, who shoulders the responsibility of the school on an everyday basis. We extend our gratitude to our dedicated teaching and non-teaching staff for their bounteousness, commitment, and wholehearted support, and thank student community for the scintillating cultural performance that will follow this formal function. We remain grateful to you, dear parents and guardians, for your benevolent support, indebted to our well-wishers, donors, and the public for a contribution to the growth of St. Mary's. Finally, I say thank you and wish you all a very pleasant and delightful morning.
Thank you, Father.
That's why I love coming to school every day. It is so much fun and full of surprises. We engage in lots of activities, which is a part of my learning.
Now, may we have the pleasure of listening to Mrs. Manjula K. Ma'am, you are requested to please take over.
Good morning, everybody. Vedike Melirva, Ella Ganyere. ವೇದಿಕೆಯ ಮುಂಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಳಿತಿರುವ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗಣ್ಯರೇ, ಈ ಶಾಲೆಯ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪೋಷಕ ವರ್ಗದವರೇ, ಶಾಲಾಭಿಮಾನಿಗಳೇ, ಮುದ್ದು ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ, ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಅದು ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಏನೇ ಇದ್ರೂ ಎಲ್ಲದನ್ನು ಮರೆಸುವ ಹಾಗೆ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಈ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಎಲ್ಲದೂ ಮರ್ತೋಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತು. ಒಂದೇ ಸಾರಿ ಅವರನ್ನೇ ನೇರ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಸಿಚುಯೇಷನ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಅವರ ಮುದ್ದು ಮುದ್ದಾಗಿ ಮಾತನಾಡುವ ರೀತಿ, ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಹೇಗೆ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಹಾಗೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಬೆಳೀತಾರೆ ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್. ಈ ಶಾಲೆ ನಿಜಕ್ಕೂ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲ ಥರದಲ್ಲಿ ತರಬೇತಿಗೊಳಿಸಿ ಮಗುವಿನ ಸರ್ವಾಂಗೀಣ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೌಲಭ್ಯವನ್ನು ಕಲ್ಪಿಸಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಮಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಮನೆಯೇ ಮೊದಲ ಪಾಠಶಾಲೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಉತ್ತಮ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಸಿಗಬೇಕು ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ಒಂದು ಉತ್ತಮ ಶಾಲೆ ಅಂತ ಆಯ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗೆ ತುಂಬ ತಿಳುವಳಿಕೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಮಗುವಿಗೆ ಯಾವ ಶಾಲೆ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಯಾವ ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಉತ್ತಮ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಗುವಿಗೆ ಪ್ರೋತ್ಸಾಹಿಸುವಂತಹ ಶಾಲೆ ಯಾವುದಿದೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಹುಡುಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅತಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಯ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿದೆ. ಇದನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದರೆ ಬಹುಶಃ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೀತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ಥರದ ಚಟುವಟಿಕೆಗಳು ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಗುಣಾತ್ಮಕ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಇದನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಮತ್ತು ಮೆಚ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಬೀತಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಹೇಗೆ ಬೆಳೆಸ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾನೂ ಸಹ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಪೇರೆಂಟಾಗಿ ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಆತ್ಮಾವಲೋಕನ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ನಾವು ಇತ್ತೀಚಿನ ಬ್ಯುಸಿ ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಸಮಯವನ್ನು ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಳೀತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ತಂದೆ ಮತ್ತು ತಾಯಿ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ದಿನಗಳಿದು. ಮತ್ತು ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಕುಟುಂಬಗಳು, ಮೊದಲೆಲ್ಲ ಅವಿಭಕ್ತ ಕುಟುಂಬ ಇತ್ತು. ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಕತೆ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಜ್ಜ ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಇದ್ದರು. ಮಕ್ಕಳಲ್ಲಿ ಮೌಲ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸದಸ್ಯರಿದ್ದರು. ಅವರ ಚಟುವಟಿಕೆಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿ, ಅವರ ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿ, ಅವರ ಕೆಲಸಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗಿಯಾಗಿ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತಹ ಕೌಶಲ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಕಲಿತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಮಕ್ಕಳು. ಲೈಫ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್, ನಾವೇನು ಇದು ಬದುಕಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಒಂದು ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಬದುಕಬೇಕಂತಂದರೆ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣಕ್ಕಿಂತನೂ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಜೀವನ ಕೌಶಲಗಳು ಬೇಕು. ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಅವಿಭಕ್ತ ಕುಟುಂಬದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಈಗ ಹಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿಗೆ ಅನುಗುಣವಾಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಕುಟುಂಬಗಳಿದ್ದು ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿರಿಯರ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಅನಿವಾರ್ಯ ಕಾರಣಗಳಿಂದ ನಾವು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಸ್ಥಳಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಅಮೂಲ್ಯ ಸಮಯವನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಕೊಡುವುದು ಹೇಗೆ? ನಾವಂತೂ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ತಾಯಂದಿರು ಎರಡೂ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಆಫೀಸಲ್ಲೂ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಅಂಥ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ನಾವು ಕಿಚನಿಗೆ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಆಗಿಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಆಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಹೇಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೆಲಸಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ತೊಡಗಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು, ಅದು ಒಂದು ಎಜುಕೇಷನೇ. ಹೇಗೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಕೆಲಸ ಹೇಳುವಂಥದ್ದು? ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಕಡೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಟಿ ವಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಳುಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಗ್ಯಾಜೆಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಪಾಡಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಇದು ಸರಿಯಾ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ನಾವು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಕೆಲಸಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ತೊಡಗಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಹೇಗೆ? ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಥರದ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣವನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಈ ಥರದ ಮೂಲಕ ಎಜುಕೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಹೇಗೆ? ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಬದುಕಬೇಕಂತಂದರೆ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ತುಂಬ ಅಗತ್ಯ ಇದೆ. ಮತ್ತು ಒಂದು ಮಗುವಿಗೆ ಬದುಕಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು, ಒಂದು ಧೈರ್ಯ ಬೇಕಂತಂದರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲಸಗಳು ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು. ಈಗ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ತುಂಬ ಮುದ್ದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ, ಏನು ಕೆಲಸ ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಕೆಲಸನೂ ಈಗ ಮಗು ಒಂದು ಸ್ಕೂಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನು ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ವಾಟರ್ ಬಾಟ್ಲಿಗೆ ನೀರು ತುಂಬಿಸೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಹಿಡಿದು ಲಂಚ್ ಬ್ಯಾಗ್ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಹಿಡಿದು ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಗ್ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಹಿಡಿದು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ಒಬ್ಬರು ನಾವು ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ನಿಗದಿಪಡಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಎಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷದವರೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ಮಗು ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರವಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಯಾವಾಗಿಂದ ಅನುವು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡಬೇಕು? ಓವರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟಿಂಗಿಂದ ಏನಾಗತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ನಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಕಾಲ. ಅಂಡರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸಹ ಅದು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದಲ್ಲ. ಕೇರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು, ಬಟ್ ಈಗಿನ ಕಾಲದ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ತುಂಬ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಒಂದು ಮಾಡರೇಟ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಬೇಕಂಥೇಳಿ ನನಗೆ ಅನಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಜುಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ, ಆ ರೀತಿ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಓವರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ದೇನೆ. ಓವರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ಪಾಯ್ಲ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾನು ಅಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಒಂದು ಮಾಡರೇಟ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೂಲಕ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಬೆಳೆಸಿದರೆ ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುವ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣದ ಜೊತೆ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಒಂದು ಭವಿಷ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಉತ್ತಮ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯಾಗಿ ರೂಪುಗೊಳ್ಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಸಾರಿ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸಮಾಜದಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಲೋಪದೋಷಗಳನ್ನು ತಿದ್ದಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವಾಗ ಅದನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮಿಂದ ಬಗೆಹರಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗಲ್ವಲ್ಲ. ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಈ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡೋಣ, ಒಂದು ಡಿ ಸಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಒಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಒಂದೊಳ್ಳೆ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯವನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೇರುವ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಇದು ಸಹ ನಾವು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಇದು ಸರಿಯಾ? ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಪ್ರಾಥಮಿಕ ವಿಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿರುವಾಗ ಮಕ್ಕಳಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಪ್ರತಿಭೆ ಇದೆ, ಯಾವ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಗುವಿಗೆ ಆಸಕ್ತಿ ಇದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ನಾವು ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂಥನ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ, ಅವರಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಲನ್ನು ಇನ್ನೂ ಶಾರ್ಪನ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ, ಅದನ್ನು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಥರದ ಎನ್ಕರೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಡೋಣ. ಆದರೆ ಮಗು ಏನಾಗಬೇಕು ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ತೊಗೊಳ್ಳೋದು ನಾವು ಸರಿಯಾ, ಒಮ್ಮೆ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಕಾಲೇಜಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಹೈಯರ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಸ್ವಂತ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಬೆಳೆಸಬೇಕು. ನಿರ್ಧಾರ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳುವಂತಹ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯ ಬರುವ ಹಾಗೆ ನಾವು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರೇ ಸ್ವತಃ ನಿರ್ಧಾರ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಅವರ ಆಸಕ್ತಿಯ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರವನ್ನು ಆಯ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಸಮಾಜಕ್ಕೆ ಉತ್ತಮ ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನು ನೀಡುವಂತಾದರೆ ಆ ಸೇವೆ ನಿಜವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಸಮಾಜಕ್ಕೆ ಲಾಭದಾಯಕವಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಂತ ನನಗನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹಾಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಇದಾಗಲೇಬೇಕು, ಐ ಐ ಟಿ ಕಳಿಸ್ಬೇಕು, ಇಲ್ಲ ನೀಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಇವಾಗಿಂದನೇ ಕೋಚಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ತುಂಬ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನನಗೆ ಕೆಲವೊಮ್ಮೆ ಫೀಲ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡೋದು ಎಷ್ಟು ಸರಿ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾವೇ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವಿಷಯ ಏನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕಂತಂದರೆ, ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು, ತುಂಬ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಸರಿನಾ? ಕೆಲವೊಮ್ಮೆ ನಾವು ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಇರಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತಾ? ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಟೈಮ್ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಸೆಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದಾ? ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಟಿ ವಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಟಿ ವಿ ನೋಡಲೇಬೇಡಿ ಅಂತ ಇವಾಗಿನ ಕಾಲದ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ? ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ, ನೋಡಲೇಬೇಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ? ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಮಯ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಯಾವಾಗ ಇರಬೇಕು, ನಾವು ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರೋರು ಮಾನಿಟರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಅದು ತುಂಬ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿಯುತವಾದಂತಹ ಕೆಲಸ. ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಏನೇ ಗ್ಯಾಜೆಟ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ? ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಕ್ಕಳಪ್ಪ ಏನೂ ನೋಡಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿರಲಿ, ಬರೇ ಕಾರ್ಟೂನ್ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಇರಲೂಬಾರ್ದು. ಒಂದು ನಾವು ಮಾನಿಟರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾದರೆ ಮಗು ಸಹ ಎಚ್ಚೆತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ಬಳಕೆ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಓ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಒಂದು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಹೇಳಿದ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸುವುದನ್ನು ಕಲೀಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ನಾವೇನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಅವರು ಪಾಲನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಟೀನೇಜ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅವರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಕಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕರಗತಗೊಳಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಹೇಗೆ, ಮಕ್ಕಳಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಇರತ್ತೆ, ನಾವು ಓದಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಓದಲ್ಲ, ಓದೋ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಲ್ಲ, ಇನ್ನೂ ಟಿ ವಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾನೆ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಹೇಗೆ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಕಾರಣ ಇದೆಯಾ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಖಂಡಿತ ಪತ್ತೆ ಹಚ್ಚಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ನನಗನ್ನಿಸ್ದಂಗೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಹಾಗೆ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ, ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಆಸಕ್ತಿಯ ಕೊರತೆ ಇರತ್ತೆ, ಅಥವಾ ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ಘಟನೆ ನಡೆದಿದೆಯಾ, ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ನಡೆದಿದೆಯಾ, ಯಾಕೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಮಂಕಾಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಯಾಕೆ ಈ ರೀತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಸೃಷ್ಟಿಯಾಗಿದೆ. ನಾವು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು, ಶಾಲೆಗೆ ಬಂದುಬಿಟ್ಟು ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಸಮಾಲೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೂ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಏನೇ ಮಾಡ್ತಾಯಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನಾವು ನಿರ್ಲಕ್ಷಿಸಲೇಬಾರ್ದು. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಮುಂದಿನ ಪ್ರಜೆಗಳನ್ನು ರೂಪಿಸುವ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ನಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಮೇಲಿದೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಕೈ ಜೋಡಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಡೌಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಶಾಲೆಗೆ ಬಂದು ಅವರು ನಿಗದಿಗೊಳಿಸಿದಂತಹ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಟೀಚರ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮಕ್ಕಳಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಬಗೆಹರಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಇನ್ನೂ ಎತ್ತರಕ್ಕೆ ತರುವಂತಹ ಆಲೋಚನೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ಈ ನಿಟ್ಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಬೆಳೆಸಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ಹಾಗೆ ಈ ಶಾಲೆ ಆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಥರದ ನಾನು ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಗಳಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಕಳೆದ ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ನಾನು ಈ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಟಚ್ಚಲ್ಲಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಗಳಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಆದ್ರೂ ತುಂಬ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥಿತವಾಗಿ, ತುಂಬ ನೀಟಾಗಿ, ತುಂಬ ಶಿಸ್ತುಬದ್ಧವಾಗಿ ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದೆಲ್ಲದೂ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಮೇಲೆ ಪರಿಣಾಮ ಬೀರತ್ತೆ. ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಜೀವನ ನಡೆಸುವ ರೀತಿಯಾಗ್ಬೋದು, ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುವಂತಹ ರೀತಿಯಾಗ್ಬೋದು, ಅದೆಲ್ಲದೂ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಚಟುವಟಿಕೆಯ ಮೇಲೆ ಪ್ರಭಾವ ಬೀರತ್ತೆ. ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಸಹ ಶಾಲೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಗೆ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಂತಂದರೆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು. ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಕಾಪಿ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು. ತಮಗೆಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋ ಹಾಗೆ ಈಗ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ನಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ನಿಮಗೆ ಮಾಡಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾರೆ, ಎಲ್ಲದನ್ನು ಎ ಟು ಝೆಡ್ ಬಂದು ತಮ್ಮ ಮುದ್ದಾದ ಮಾತುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ದೊಡ್ಡವರನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಕಾಪಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಆ ರೀತಿ ಕಾಪಿ ಮಾಡುವ ಮನೋಭಾವ ಹೊಂದಿರುವಾಗ ನಮ್ಮ ನಡವಳಿಕೆಗಳು ಹೇಗಿರಬೇಕು, ನಾವು ಪೇರೆಂಟಾಗಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿರುವಾಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂಭಾಷಣೆಗಳು ಹೇಗಿರಬೇಕು, ನಮ್ಮ ಎಮೋಷನ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೇಗಿರಬೇಕು, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನಾವು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಲವಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಮಗು ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣವಾಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಥರದ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಆಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಸಹಕರಿಸಿದ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಈ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ನಾವು ನೀವು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೇರಿ ಈ ಭವಿಷ್ಯದ ಪ್ರಜೆಗಳನ್ನು ಉತ್ತಮ ಪ್ರಜೆಗಳನ್ನಾಗಿ, ಆರೋಗ್ಯವಂತ ಪ್ರಜೆಗಳನ್ನಾಗಿ ರೂಪಿಸಿ ಒಂದು ಸದೃಢ ಭಾರತವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ಮಾಣ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಈ ದಿನ ನಡೆಯುವಂತಹ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ವರ್ಣರಂಜಿತ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಮೂಡಿ ಬರಲಿ, ತಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಸಂತೋಷವನ್ನು ಅನುಭವಿಸಿ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾನು ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಶಿಸ್ತಾ ನನ್ನ ಎರಡು ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ಮುಗಿಸ್ತೀನಿ. ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು.
Thank you, ma'am, for sharing your views.
May we request our beloved correspondent to deliver his presidential address.
Our esteemed chief guest of the day, Mrs. Manjula K., the Block Education Officer of Udupi, Reverend Father Principal and Vice Principal Madam, Mr. Gracian Botello, representative of the managing committee on the dais, and the managing committee members who are present here, Mr. Maxim D'Souza and Mrs. Benedicta Fernandez, Reverend Father Stephen Fernandez, our invited guests, my dear parents, relatives, and well-wishers of St. Mary's. We have carefully listened to the report presented by the principal and also the lovely words of encouragement and advice given to us by our chief guest. We are happy and proud to say that the chief guest, Mrs. Manjula, has her daughter here in St. Mary's. And as a parent and an educationist, it is our privilege today to have her with us on this unique occasion. Thank you, madam, for those words of appreciation and guidance that you have given to the school and to all the parents. My dear friends, I was here to welcome these kids on the first day of their school. And in a few months, I'm again here in your presence to observe how much they have been transformed. As our chief guest noted, they have not only been trained by our teachers in academic education, but also co-curricular and extracurricular activities. I would like to congratulate these two little MCs of ours. You will see them with no paper in hand, with a mic well used. Even if there is a sore throat, they don't bother. Difficulties are no hurdles, and they are here to present their program to all of us. Shall we give them a good clap, please? Congratulations to both of you. You look very handsome and pretty today. Well, children or kids are the best gifts that any parent can receive from God. And these precious images of God that you have in your hands in the form of your children are the greatest gifts that you have received from God. As they grow up, it is your pleasure and our pleasure from the school, the management staff, and all those who cooperate with us to see that they grow and grow into responsible citizens with sound moral values. St. Mary's stands for quality. We have an excellent, huge, nearly 10-acre campus, excellent infrastructure, and I must congratulate all the parents of this institution because you are blessed. If you feed your child to the KG, you can get a second year PUC or 12th standard pass from the CBSE in one campus and in under one roof. This is a rare privilege. We have a new principal as the new dynamic leader of this institution. Reverend Father Johnson Sequeira has taken charge of this institution as the principal on May 27. Now she is ably supported by our vice principal, Mrs. Rita Quadras, and all the coordinators of the various sections and all the members of the teaching and non-teaching staff. There is only one aim for this institution, and the aim is the welfare of every student who comes into this institution. You, dear parents, when you bring your child for admission into the school or the institution, I'm sure you carry a load of expectations. But as they are being unfolded, as they are being realized in your presence, with your cooperation, with the teachers and the administration, you will feel a sense of fulfillment and contentment that your child is growing in the love of God and the love of human beings, fellow beings. What else is required? When the person is blooming in all the qualities, all the talents and gifts that the Lord has instilled into each one of them, it is a great grace and a gift to every parent and a teacher to see that they shine in the respective fields of their specialization. Well, we are very happy and proud today to feel that the Lord has blessed this institution through our patron, Mother Mary. We have a body of nearly 1,450 students who are bubbling with life, who are highly gifted and talented. It is your duty and our duty to not to mislead them, to lead them on the right path. We need to have a clear vision, a clear mission, a clear goal with clear objectives. The institution's vision and mission are displayed at the entrance. We have a clear vision of presenting socially responsible and morally upright global citizens and leaders to our society. And this, in our mission, we want to achieve this through academic and value education. There is no discrimination of creed, caste, or whatever. Once a student enters this campus, he is a student of St. Mary's. On the 14th, on the Children's Day, we had a lovely celebration with kids. And we sang together, Amma navu chinnarella shalekhe hoki Odukalitu baruve vamma jhanaraghi. Such songs were being sung in our childhood. Amma navu chinnarella shalekhe hoki Odukalitu baruve vamma jhanaraghi. I hope these dreams will be realized in the lives of every student that you have presented to St. Mary's. I thank all the parents for your kind cooperation with the school and the administration, and I wish all the best and I congratulate all the students who are going to take part in these various cultural presentations which are going to follow this stage program. I'm sure they have been waiting for this for hours. All made up and well painted and all ready. They are bubbling with life. I hope every one of you will have an enjoyable day at St. Mary's. Thank you all. God bless you.
Thank you, Father, for the loving message. Now, we request our correspondent to hand our memento to our dear guest as a token of love and affection. Thank you, Father.
Here comes Daivik of UKGB to propose the vote of thanks.
A very grand morning to everyone. Gratitude unlocks the fullness of life. It can turn a meal into a feast, a house into a home, and a stranger into a friend. Each one of us have a cause to think with deep gratitude of those who have lighted the flame within us. Saying thank you creates love. It's my privilege to propose the word of thanks on this beautiful day. Our joy is boundless as Mrs. Manjula K. accepted our invitation and is here to grace a special day. A big thank you to you for taking out time from the busy schedule to share with us this annual day. Thank you, ma'am. We are grateful to our beloved correspondent, Very Reverend Father Valerian Mendoza, who is with us, keeping up his work to appreciate us. Thank you, dear Father. sincere thanks to Mr. Gresham Botello, Secretary, Management Committee members and Association Council. We thank our principal, Reverend Father Johnson Sequeira, who encourages us to take part in all the activities we participate. Thank you, dear Father. We thank our Vice Principal, Mrs. Rita Cordes, for her constant support. Thank you, ma'am. Our gratitude is due to all the parents, grandparents, uncles and aunts who have supported us in all the possible ways. Thank you all. Thanks to all my teachers who put in their effort day and night to bring out the best in us. Thank you, teacher. A sincere thanks to the non-teaching staff, without whom nothing goes smoothly. Thank you. A sincere thanks to the stage setters, photographers, sound light engineers who add color and festivities to this event. Thank you all. Thanks to all my friends who are the twinkling stars of today's program. Thank you, friends, for your cooperation. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Devi. Now I request Dapsi ma'am to formally propose the vote of thanks.
This is the day that Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. While thanking the Almighty for His countless blessings, I am here to spell out words of gratitude to every noble heart who contributed towards the success of today's event. Gratitude is not only the greatest of virtues, but the parent of all others. A delightful morning to the amazing people with great hearts gathered here. We raise our hearts and give thanks to the Lord for His unfailing love. His love endures forever. Thank you is a small word, because under your spiritual guidance, we experience God's love. Our very own correspondent, Reverend Father Valerian Mendonca, a man of simplicity, high thinking and insight, perfectionist, and above all, a great musician, has conquered the minds and hearts of many. With high regards, we extend our ardent gratitude who, having spent this day with us, with your thought-provoking words. Thank you, Father. I would like to take this opportunity to place on record our hearty thanks to our Honorable Chief Guest, Mrs. Manjula K, for being part over this colorful festivity. We are greatly encouraged by your gracious presence and immensely benefited by your inspiring address. Thank you, ma'am. I extend my gratitude to Mr. Gresham Botello, the Secretary Parish Pastoral Council of Mother of Sorrows Church, Udupi, and also the Management Committee members for their support and extending hands when in need. We are much obliged for the same. If niceness is your way, happiness can never be away. God gave us the eyes, but you showed us the skies. For awakening the desires and wonders of young generations and sharpening their educational agenda, our philosopher, mentor, our guide, who has brought a tremendous charm to the St. Mary's family, our most dearest principal, Father Johnson Sequeira, your actions inspire others, and you explore the possibilities and help us to reach the new horizon. We are beholden to you for being the author of an ambition to our students and an inspiration to the faculty. Your hard work and dedication will always be admired. Thank you, Father. Love includes everyone, excludes none. Our loving, caring, and affectionate Vice Principal, Mrs. Rita Quadras, who is always ready with open hands to help and support us in every need that we are in need. We owe you a debt of gratitude for all that you have done. Thank you, ma'am. When parents or guardians and teachers work together well, everyone wins. Our sincere thanks to you, our dear parents and guardians, for your excellent cooperation, dedication, endless support, and for being the key players in our successful events. You have a special place in our thoughts. You made us find our best. Thank you. We feel proud and honored to spell out words of thanks for the dignitaries from various institutions, reverend fathers, religious sisters, and well-wishers for esteemed presence here. We owe our gratitude to each one of you. Someone sitting in the shade today because someone planted a tree a long time ago. Behind every successful program lies the manifold effort of committed faculty. With deep sense of appreciation, we recall the tireless efforts of our loving teachers for imparting perfect training to the toddlers. Make this a day memorable one. Thank you, teachers. We are so thankful to our non-teaching faculty, especially our caretakers, school bus drivers, and conductors who humbly render their helping hands with great gesture and kindness beyond their comfort zone. Our sincere thanks to the provision of appropriate sound and music system, our faculty stage setters, photographer, and media personnel who added color and festivity to the event. The essence of the fruits is tasted until last. We believe the last is the best ever. We are here to thank our little angels, the blooming buds of St. Mary's, for the incredible performance in various programs on stage, including the Masters of Ceremonies. You are the central focus of not only today's program, but every moment of your stay in this temple of learning. On behalf of our institution, I express my sincere gratitude to all Tiny Tots for being disciplined and honest. Thank you, children. And now, with folded hands, much respect and reverence, I would take this opportunity to wind up with a quote. The more you praise and celebrate your life, the more there is in life to celebrate. Thank you, stay blessed, and take care.
Thank you, ma'am.
Here we come to the end of the formal program. Now, I request our dear guests to occupy the place in front of the desk.
A big thank you from Ayan
and Charvi. We will soon begin the cultural program. Wish you all a very pleasant day.
We hand over the mic to Alicia and Ashwin to take you through the program that follows.
And I, Ashwin, wish you all a very happy and pleasant morning.
Namaskara.
Pranam.
Sastriyakal.
Dev Vadodis Dev.
Swagatam.
Vadakam.
We are very much excited as we all are going to show our talents to all of you.
We all love nature, isn't it, Ashwin?
Yes, Alisha, some love nature for its lush greenery, breathtaking beauty.
Oh yeah, Ashwath.
Yes, and also some love for its gifts such as trees, flowers, birds, animals, etc., etc.
We all have been working very hard, so please don't stop clapping and cheering for us. Let us have a glimpse of melodies of nature. Now
please sit back, enjoy the program, carry back good memories, and have a great time. Enjoy the show.
Now our friends from UKG are here to welcome everyone with a dance.
Smile on a face with love. ಶಾಲೆಗೋಗಲು ಇಷ್ಟವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ.
ಏನು ಶಾಲೆಗೆ ಹೋಗಲು ಇಷ್ಟವಿಲ್ಲವೇ? ಯಾಕೆ?
ನನಗೆ ಆಟ ಆಡಬೇಕು.
ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಆಟ ಆಡ್ಬೋದಲ್ಲ, ಬಾ, ನಿನ್ನ ಬಣ್ಣದ ಲೋಕಕ್ಕೆ ಕರೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗುತ್ತೇನೆ.
ಏನು ಬಣ್ಣ ಲೋಕವೇ?
ಹೌದು, ಬಣ್ಣದ ಲೋಕ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಮನ ಬಿಲ್ಲು, ಹಕ್ಕಿಗಳ ಚಿಲಿಪಿಲಿ, ನಡುವೆ ಶಾಲೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಸಂಭ್ರಮ.
ಹೌದೇ?
ನಡಿ, ನಿನ್ನನ್ನು ಆ ಬಣ್ಣದ ಲೋಕಕ್ಕೆ ಕರೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗುತ್ತೇನೆ. ನಾ ವಿ ದ ಟೈನಿ ಟಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೆಜಿಸಿ ಆರ್ಯ ಟು ಶೋ ದ ಫೆಸ್ಟಿವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈನ್ಬೋ.
ಕಾಮನ ಬಿಲ್ಲಿನ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೂಗುತ್ತ ಸಾಗುವ ರೈಲಿದೆ ಜುಗು 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 ಜುಗು. ಬೆಳ್ಳಿಯ ದೀಪದ ಚಂಬ ಚಂದಚ್ಚಿ ಮಾಮನ ಚೈಲಿದೆ ಜುಗು 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 ಜುಗು. ಹಾರುವ ಹಕ್ಕಿಯ ಜೊತೆ ಹಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಶಾಲೆಯ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಜೊತೆ ಕೂಡಿಕೊಂಡು
ಬಂದು ಜೈ ಡ್ರಾಬ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಐಸ್ ತಿಂದ ತಕ್ಕ day. Come, let's go to garden to play.
Yes, it's very wonderful outside. Today you will see birds and hear them chirping, the clouds, the sun, play around.
Yes, our earth is so beautiful, with green trees, colorful flowers, sky smiling down on nature in a lap of our earth.
Come, let's call our friends from LKGD section.
Oh, during my holidays,
I always go to grandparents' home. There I love to spend time with beautiful nature.
What is that beautiful nature, Susie? Here we have so many big mouths and paws. We can good time.
No, you must see the beauty of the nature where we have cute trees, nest of the birds, beautiful teenage flowers, and the grass and the greenery all around. Come, I will narrate you more about nature.
Oh, Hi, Sagar.
Do you know the name of the planet which we live in?
Yes, Sagar. The Earth is the planet which we live in.
Yes, you are right. Now tell me, isn't our nature very beautiful?
Yes, our nature is very beautiful, with full of trees and flowers. Look at the sun, mountains, trees, flowers and birds.
These are river mountains. They are not only beautiful, but teach us to be strong in all situations.
Now let's welcome our dear friends to witness today's colorfulness about nature from UKGD section.
We've got the whole world in our hands. We've got the whole world in our hands. We've got the whole world in our hands. We've got the whole world in our hands.
She's got the sun and the moon
in her hands.
She's got the sun and
mountains and the valleys in his hands. He's got the mountains and the valleys in his hands. He's got the mountains and the valleys in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. The lakes and the rivers in his hands. He's got the lakes and the rivers in his hands. He's got the lakes and the rivers in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
She's got the trees and the flowers
in her hands.
She's got the trees and the flowers
in her hands.
She's got the trees and the flowers.
He's got the birds of the air in his hands. He's got the birds of the air in his hands. He's got the birds of the air in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
We should, and it's time we're aware. It's just
Do you know today's our annual day?
Yes, yes, Dishen. I'm so excited. Today we all will dance and show our love for our environment.
Hansini, what is environment?
You know, Dishen, the sun, moon, stars, sky, animals, birds, everything around us, living and non-living, makes up our environment.
Okay. And what are we, the children of UKGC, going to do?
Our dance is the flight of the future.
Now what is that?
Dishen, we will show how a small chick grows up with the help of her mother and learns to live her life in the jungle. Also, the harmful effects of the bubble tower the little birds face. Come, let's go and see.
Okay, let's go.
Kinga, kinga, kinga. Birds like me, cause I'm a hot winga.
Where's your hot winga?
Ah!
Everybody loves samba.
I like the samba.
Rhythm you feel in your heart.
I'm the samba master.
Beauty and love. What more could you want? There is he can be for me.
Outdoor. We reap plenty of benefits from playing outside.
Yes, I know. The love as well. Especially, I love to watch colorful flowers. The butterflies that fly around, the birds chirping and peacock dancing, and animals happily running around.
Oh yes, come on Nandita. Let's go and join our friends to play.
Suraj aata din aata hai, Suraj jata hoti raat, tab chanda. जितना गरम चांदनी चंदा की उतनी ठंडी बिना चांद के लगती कितनी सुंदर तारों की मंडी
शहजादी हो परी लोक से
about different wild animals live in forest. Have you visited a forest?
Yes, I remember we learned different wild animals live in forest. The giraffe has a long neck. The zebra has black and white stripes on his body.
Wait, Fiber, wait. Let us visit the forest and see the animals for ourselves. How they look. I love to see them. Let's go, Vaibhavi.
Okay, let's go with the UKGB section, friends.
Okay, let's go.
Ha ha ha! Away the mighty jackfruit tree teakwood tree and gooseberry tree. The sparrow prays to God to save her nest and the banana plant. The winds blow harder, but the banana plant withstands the wind. And after some time, the wind and thunder stops. The sparrow says,
"Thank you, God, for saving us. The banana plant was very kind and loving for giving me space to build my nest."
The moral
of the story is, help others during bad times. God will always reward you for that.
God bless the banana plant by growing many new saplings for her.
Thank you.
Have you been?
Hello, Pragun. I am on the way to park.
What are you munching?
Oh, this is my favorite Kurkure. Would you like to have?
Oh, no, thank you. But don't you know, this chunk is so bad for our health. And moreover, this plastic in which the junk is packed. Our teacher has told us that these plastic waste are not good. They're harmful for everyone.
I never knew this before. Can you please tell me more about this?
MMS also told us not to drink water in single-use bottles. So, plastic bottles are not allowed in our school. The animals and tiles can stay plastic for food, which we throw here and there.
Oh my goodness, my parents also telling me about this. Plastic has toxic that damage our environment and cause pollution. Thank you for MNS Pragun. My friends must be waiting for me in the park. Would you like to join us to play?
Oh yes, we shall all together avoid using plastic and try to save the environment.
We, the children of UKG A section, are here to share the awareness about plastic pollution with an act and spectacular dance.
Thank you.
tick, kasam ye khaye re. Tick 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 tick, plastic tick na paaye re. अगर सुन लो जज़्ब लेना हम तो हम ये फट जाएगा के बहती सी है नदिया का ये पानी रुक जाएगा
अगर सुन लो जज़्ब लेना हम तो हम ये फट जाएगा के बहती सी है नदिया का ये पानी रुक जाएगा
के कर दो रहम धरती का ये दम भी घुट जाएगा कुदरत की हनस नस में जहर ये बस जाएगा प्लास्टिक के हम सब मोहताज हैं कैसा ये समाज है
बनाए
जगह बनाए
याद दिला दे प्लास्टिक को हम उसकी नानी, याद दिला दे प्लास्टिक को हम उसकी नानी। ये सोच सयानी। छोड़ो प्लास्टिक थैली, हम सब ने अब ठानी, अपना लो कपड़े की कोई थैली नई पुरानी। ये सोच सयानी।
Program. Hope you enjoyed watching it as much as we enjoyed presenting it.
Thank you for being a great audience. God has created a beautiful nature for the healthy living of us. Nature is a great teacher.
Nature has enough for man's need, but not for man's greed.
Let us all join our
hands to conserve our beautiful Mother Nature. Now I, Ashwath,
and I, Alicia, sign off.
Thank you all.
Now I request everyone